Welcome you students, our topic is product of inertia or product moment of plane area. In order to understand the product of inertia, just consider an example. So for that, just take a plane area, and this is the centroid of it. So I can say the axis passing through this centroid, which is called the centroidal axis. Okay, axis passing through the centroid, which is centroidal axis. So this is the xx and this is yy and this is o. So I'm going to take the area, plane area is capital A. Here I just going to consider a small element. That particular area I going to consider as dA. Okay, it's a dA. And ox, this distance is y, and from O y this distance is x. Okay, let it be. So I just going to take the first moment about O x axis. Then I can say I x will be, which is equal to y into dA. That means first moment is nothing but area into its perpendicular distance. I have taken OX axis, so dA into its perpendicular distance y. So for that, for this first moment about OX, I just going to take second moment, but it's about y axis. Then I can say Ixy, which will be equal to y axis. So here it will be xy into dA. Okay, xy into dA. So if I consider for the product of inertia, which is Ixy for entire object or entire area, I can say it will be Ixy, which is equal to integral. If you integrate this particular thing, you will get it Ixy into dA, right? And this product of inertia unit concern, it is meter per 4. Here see, area is in the sense meter square, and here product of x and y, x will be meter and here will be meter. So entirely we will get meter per 4 or centimeter per 4 or millimeter per 4. This will be the unit. And here the important note we need to take. Okay, the moment of inertia, first one is the moment of inertia for Ixx, Iyy is always positive. Okay, but the moment of inertia or product of inertia, okay, product of inertia will not be always zero. It can be positive, it can be negative, or it can be zero. Okay, so here the moment of inertia Ixx and Iyy always positive answer will be, here it can be positive, it can be negative, or it can be zero as well. Okay, for some of the areas, like when you are having the symmetric area, then I can say its product of inertia will be zero. I just will show some kind of area for your better understanding. Okay, so I just going to take this C section. This is the C section. If we take with respect to the x-axis, then I can say above and below, it is mirror image. Both are same, right? Below and above. This kind of object, we can say it is symmetric about x-axis. So this section, since symmetric about x axis, here the product moment of inertia will be zero. Okay, product moment of inertia will be zero. The similar fashion, if you take it for I section, this is the section, we call it as I section. Okay, this is the I section. Here x axis, y axis. So here in the I section, it is symmetric about y axis, left and right. If you see, the object is same, left side is just mirror of right side. So I y, it is symmetric about y axis. Okay, so that I x y, which is equal to zero, product moment of inertia, which is equal to zero. If it is a rectangle, then see, it is symmetric about xx and yy. It also xy, product moment of inertia will be a zero. Here this, it is symmetric about xx and yy. So when you are coming across this symmetric object or symmetric areas, then you can just come to a conclusion, IHY will be S0.
And the next is formula for product of inertia. Okay, so formula concern only one, the simple shape which has the product of inertia, which is nothing but triangle. Right angle triangle IXX is B square H square divided by 72. Okay, so all the others like square, rectangle, circle, quadrant, semicircle, isosceles triangle, all the other thing, x product of inertia IXY, which is equal to zero. Okay, so whenever you are having symmetric figure or symmetric plane, okay, it also has no product of inertia, which is equal to zero. So here the right angle triangle has the product of inertia, which is b square h square divided by 72, and all the other shapes which has the zero product of inertia, especially when you are coming across the symmetric or plane figures, just put it in your mind, definitely the product of inertia is equal to zero. Okay, so these three things we must remember when you are solving the problems. Okay, and when you are having the compound planes, okay, when you are having compound planes, the formula for the product of inertia is IXY, which is equal to sum of IXY plus sum of area into H dash Y dash. Right, so this is the HZ formula when you are coming across the compound planes. Okay, when you are solving the problems, we'll be just substituting these kind of things. Sum of IXY, in the sense, all the individual components, self product of inertia, and plus sum of area into H dash Y dash. Area, in the sense, it's a self area of each components in the compound planes. X dash is nothing but it is the distance between the x core and the self centroid of the particular component. The similar fashion, y dash in the sense nothing but the self centroid of the particular component and the y bar. Okay, the entire compound plane centroid and the difference between the self centroid of the particular component we are analyzing. So that difference is x dash and y dash. Okay, so I hope you understood the concept of product of inertia and what are the formula involves in and how will you carry out when you are having the compound planes. Thank you so much.